Algebra 2, this is chapter 6, section 2. This is example 4 of 5. So now we're going to see if we can figure out the roots, and it's going to be not exact roots this time, so we're not going to get answers of 2 and 7. We're going to get something in between, and then how you're supposed to actually document that when that's what you end up with. So again, we're back to graphing, and graphing by plotting points, because again, that's the only tool in your toolbox at this point. So I will start with trusty old 0 here. So 0 squared is 0, and 6 times 0 is 0, and plus 3, so that gives me 0, 3. And we'll go to the next point. Let's try 1, see what 1 does. So 1 squared is 1, 6 times 1 is 6, and plus 3. So this is going to be, oh, by the way, this is a positive a, so we know that this is something that looks like that. So 1 minus 6 is negative 5, plus 3 would be a negative 2. Or 1 plus 3 is 4, and 6 and 4 makes 2. Moving on, I'm at a negative 2 here, so I went from 0, negative, so let's keep going in that direction, see what happens. So at 2, this would be 4, minus 24, oh, this is getting way big. Maybe I should go the other direction and see what I get. Because this is going to be a huge number. So this would be 7, 24 minus 7 is going to be negative 17. So going the other way, let's try negative 1 and see where that puts me. So negative 1 squared is positive 1, and negative 1 times a negative 6 is a positive 6, and plus 3, this is going to be 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is a 10. Okay, so I've got some questions here. I don't think this point here is right, so I'm just going to erase this one. Oops, we'll see. I'm going to go back and redo this point here, because I don't think that's right. So let me try that again. I've got to have a mistake here. So 2 squared is 4. 2 times 6 would be a negative 12 plus 3. Aha. So it's not negative 17. This is positive, and this is positive. This is negative. So it's negative 12 plus 7, which makes that number right there not that number. Let's fix that. That should be a negative, 5? Okay, that makes more sense. Okay, so let me plot these points and see what I have so far. So 0, 3 is right here, off my graph again. 1, negative 2 is here. 2, 3, 4, 5. I need to come down a little bit. So this is 2, negative 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then at negative 1, I'm all the way up at 10, so I'm not going to graph that one. And let me see what happens when I get to 3 here. And we're starting to get closer together, so I know that my minimum is going to be over here somewhere. So let me grab and get rid of this. I'm trying 3 this time, so 3 squared is 9, 3 times 6 is minus 18, plus 3, so that's going to be negative 9, so this is going to be a negative 6, so at 3 I'm at negative 6, there I'm a lot closer now, so I am finding the bottom of my parabola, so we'll go 4, like that. So 4 squared is 16, 4 times 6 is 24, plus 3, so this is a 19, so this would be a negative 5 again. Here's my negative 5, and you can see we're starting to come back up, so that means the next point has to be here, and the next one over here is going to be out here. So then I can draw my parabola, if all goes well. I still have plenty of room for this. Only mildly lumpy of a parabola. So it's got a minimum, and my minimum is right there. It's got two solutions. Okay, my solution here and over there are this where it crosses the x-axis. So I have, and let's read the directions and what it wants. If exact roots cannot be found, state the consecutive integers between which the roots are located. So 0 is an integer and 1 is an integer, and the root is between them. So between 0 and 1. And then this is 2, 3, 4, 5 between 5 and 6. And this is how you would write your answer if the given question was in this form. So state the consecutive integers between which the roots are located, between 0 and 1, and between 5 and 6.